Melissa Francis joined Fox Business Network as an anchor in January 2012 and is now the host of Money with Melissa Francis, a daily show airing on FBN. But Melissa isn't new to television. In fact, she started at a very young age on a show you might have heard of called Little House on the Prairie. We sat down with Melissa on the set of her show at the Fox News Studios in Manhattan, New York, to discuss life on TV, family, and so much more. Thanks for having us, by the way.
My pleasure. Really appreciate it. Yeah.
So, you know, the big question on my mind was, I knew you from Little House on the Prairie.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah, that's right. So you know I'm not really blonde. I'm in big trouble.
Yeah. Oh, well,
I know.
Yeah. It's all right. You paid for it. You earned it.
I did. You know. No, I grew up in Hollywood. I was a child actor. I did, you know, my first job when I was 6 months old, a Johnson & Johnson baby shampoo commercial.
And so you're a real cute baby?
I don't know. I mean, maybe. I hope so.
You still look good. Maybe you carry through. I love it.
So I did lots of commercials and, you know, entertainment the whole time I was growing up in L.A. I was a real Hollywood kid.
And you wrote a book about that, about your experiences.
I did, Diary of a Stage Mother's Daughter. It was out about a year ago. It's in paperback now and flying off the shelves. And, you know, I wrote every word of it myself. It's straight from the heart. And it was about, you know, both the pros and the struggles of growing up in Hollywood and the confidence that it gives you and then also, you know, the real challenges that it presents. And
yeah, with all the rejections, obviously, because there's auditions and rejection and it's how your family deals with it as well,
definitely.
Probably.
No, definitely. And I, you know, I had a stage mom, as you can tell from the
title
of the book. And it just became a very relevant discussion at a time when tiger parenting is out there and people are really pushing their kids. I wanted to sort of show the other side of what can happen when you push your kids. So
yeah, and you didn't break. You can either break or you can excel, and it seems like you became stronger.
For me, it worked out. For my sister, you know, it was a lot tougher, and you know, it really chronicled the whole thing in the book, so I don't want to spoil the end of it, but you can really see both sides of how it can turn out, I'll tell
you
that
much. Yeah, it sounds like a very interesting
book. Yeah, very dramatic, yeah.
A Mommy Dearest type thing, in a way, but not as hardcore.
Kind of, yeah, I'd like to say a little softer, a little more serious. It also, you know, you'll leave in a lot of parts laughing as well, so there you go.
It's good to have a laugh, you know?
Yeah.
So now, from there,
You
had the acting bug, and you've done it for many, many years.
How did
you end up in finance?
Well, you know, I went off to Harvard because I wanted to sort of really shake up my life and be a completely different part of the country where I couldn't go on auditions no matter what and see if it drew me back and I had to go back to Hollywood or if there was something else I wanted to do with my life. And, you know, I majored in economics and I went looking around for a summer job and I got a summer internship for actually the local Fox affiliate in LA. And to me, it was so different from acting because news is really all about, especially in this day and age, what's coming from your mind and your heart. You're not acting out lines.
It's more of a commentary, right? Yeah.
It is. You're not acting out lines that someone else is writing. I mean, my show, Money, is almost completely unscripted. You know, we script the intros to the discussions, but when we're sitting there, we're debating, we're talking. You know, it's very much a back and forth, and they're all ideas that are coming from me. The segment ideas are coming from me and my team as we sit around and talk. So for me, news was, you know, a lot more intellectual, and it was more about what I was interested in versus acting, where you're kind of a puppet and you're, you know, inhabiting a character that someone else invented.
Right, and if you're into the character, great, you might have a great day, but if not, you have to, you're at work.
Yeah,
yeah, and
absolutely.
They always say, if you do what you love, you don't work a day in your life, so.
That's true.
So that sounds like what you're doing.
Absolutely.
Well, now, it was pretty interesting because it wasn't necessarily like handed to you on a silver platter.
Yeah.
The way you got involved was pretty interesting.
The way I got into news, this is a tough business, and so it's tough business to break into. I remember it was my senior year at Harvard, and I was looking for a job, and you know, all my classmates were going off to banks and to law school and to medical school. I would rent a car and get my resume tapes and my resume and go out in this rental and try and convince news directors to see me. And I remember I would call an affiliate and say, hey, I'm coming into town next week to see your competition. Can I stop by and drop off a tape in a resume? It was a lie.
Right.
I didn't really have an interview, but they would say, sure, come on in. Then I would call the other guy and say, hey, I'm coming to see, you know, the ABC guy. Can I come see you at NBC? And they would say, sure. And, you know, I did that. I went around to all the little towns, everything that was driving distance from Cambridge, Massachusetts. And I landed my first job in Maine, and I was sort of off to the races.
you're a hustler. That's the bottom line, right?
I guess so. I don't know if that's a flattering term for a woman.
For me, it is. I think that's great. You're a go-getter.
I'm a go-getter. I like that. I'm ambitious.
And women, and that's good. We should all be go-getters, right? That's how you get things in life.
In this economy, you have to be. I mean, we say that on my show all the time, that it's not the kind of economy where anything is handed to you on a silver platter, and you've got to kind of make it happen for yourself. And whether that's starting your own franchise, starting your own business. I mean, today on the show, we had a kid who has 1 billion views on YouTube.
And it's a kid, so you can relate because you've been there, right?
Yeah, but it's about making it happen for yourself. Yeah, 1 billion views. Can
you
imagine? 2.3 million people have signed up for his channel. He makes more than $500,000 a year. I had to have him on the show to show our viewers, how can you get into this business and make this happen for yourself? Because with money and the economy today, you have to do it yourself.
Yeah, you do. And you appreciate it more, right? When it's given to you.
I think so, yeah.
There you go.
Yeah,
I love it.
I hope so.
Well, now you're a busy mom, too. You have two children.
I do.
Now, you planned it all out. I love your story.
Yeah.
How you and your husband met in school.
We met in college, and we were married for a while before we had kids because we were both, you know, really loved her. He's in finance, and we had sort of that crossover. I was always been a financial journalist. But we waited to have kids because we both, you know, were really into our jobs and stuff. And now we have 2 sons that are 4 and 7. Wow. And I have to say that every cliche they say about kids is absolutely true. I mean, they are the light of my life. And
absolutely.
I'm lucky Fox is so supportive of families. You know, I'm able to, I really, you know, I'm like so many working moms. Get up in the morning, make breakfast. You know, I get them ready for school, drop them off. I come here. We have our show meeting. I get ready, get all glammed up, do my show. And then I'm back usually in time, you know, to pick them up from their after school activities. We have dinner, do homework, you know, like a lot of moms.
That's the best.
Yeah,
you have a normal
great.
Life. Now, what if your kids wanted to get into acting on, what would your be word of advice?
You know, people ask me that all the time, and it's hysterical because my kids are not cooperative enough to do it.
Okay.
I mean, the number one thing about me as a kid growing up, and now I really realize it, I was a pleaser, you know, so I was happy to follow direction and do, and I liked the attention. And I think that while my kids love attention, I'm not sure they're quite cooperative enough to sit there, learn your lines, be silent, you know, hit your mark, do it 1 million times. You have to stay in a good mood for a really long period of time. I mean, when you see kids who are actors, it's a lot of work.
A lot
and
of
they
discipline.
Have to be really mature. It's a lot of discipline. And, you know, if they don't love it, it's very hard for me to believe that kids that don't love doing it are successful. You know, you see kids out there and you have to like it, right? I think you're not good at it because you wouldn't cooperate.
Well, and you live in the city, which is incredible.
Yeah.
So, I mean, this is an incredible city, by the way.
It's
so
fun.
How do the kids like living here? And how is it having a family in the city?
They love Manhattan. You know, people say you don't have a yard, and I say we have the biggest backyard you've ever seen. It's Central Park and all the museums and everything you have out there. I mean, we can go out on foot and do almost anything. We have so many adventures over the weekend, and we really take advantage of everything the city has to offer. And, you know, for now, it fits us really well. So we love it. Yeah.
Well, I'm glad you're here. I'm glad you're helping people with money and sharing your concepts. That's what I really like, the fact that you are taking what's in here, you're condensing it down, and you're distilling it and giving it to the public.
Yeah,
wonderful.
Absolutely.
Well, thanks
thank
so much
you.
For stopping on by with us and
thank you.
Letting me stop by with you.
Loved having you. Come back soon.
Okay, we sure will. And thank you so much for being here with us. And until next time, just remember to
enjoy.